Hello YouTube friends, lovely to see you again. I know, it's been a while. It's probably been like 9 or 10 days, I think, since I filmed a video, which is a really long time for me. And I really don't have a valid excuse other than I just kind of needed a break. I normally film my videos on weekends, and last weekend was just really nice outside, and I just kind of felt like I wanted to just go out and have some fun and spend some time with my friends and family and not really have to worry about filming. So I'm sure you guys can understand girls need for a break, so I'm sorry I've been gone, but I'm back now. So what's been going on while I've been gone? Okay, so last weekend we lost Amy Winehouse, and I'm so sad. Those of you guys who follow me on Twitter and Facebook know I love me some Amy Winehouse. Ever since Back to Black came out, actually before that, her first album Frank I loved so much, but Back to Black, for me, you guys know how some singers, they just put out these albums and you feel like they're talking just to you, and that's how I feel about Back to Black, just because I was going through a really awful breakup when that album came out, and it just really helped me out. Like, I almost felt like Amy was in my head listening to my thoughts and saying them out loud, and it was just, it's seriously on my top 5 albums of all time. I still listen to it at least once or twice a week. Even before she passed, I was still listening to it regularly because men still suck just as they did then, and I'm probably gonna still be listening to it when I'm 90 because they're probably still gonna suck when I'm 90. So okay, what am I talking to you guys about today? Oh, okay, so last month I totally spaced out on doing my favorites video. I don't know why, I just like forgot. So anyways, I'm just gonna do a June and July favorites. I actually don't have a whole lot to talk about just because there wasn't a whole lot that really made an impression. So I'm just gonna get right into it because I don't want this to be like a 15-minute video where I'm just talking about products. As always, I'm going to start things off with a product that I hate. So this was about 3 weeks ago. I was out of conditioner. I was grocery shopping at this store called Trader Joe's that we have on the West Coast. It's like a health food store, and they actually have pretty good stuff there. And I really didn't feel like making an extra trip to Target to get my Pantene that I normally use. And they had this Nourish Spa Balanced Moisturizing Conditioner. And I figured, you know what? It's moisturizing, whatever. I don't feel like driving all the way to Target, even though it's in the same shopping center. I know. So I went ahead and got this, and I absolutely hate it. First of all, look at how much I had to use. This was just one use. This is how much it took to actually detangle my hair. This didn't moisturize anything, okay? And it left this disgusting residue in my hair, and it smells like candle wax, and not like scented candle wax. It smells like church candle wax. It's gross. And I don't have a problem with the way church candles smell when I'm at church, but I don't want my hair to smell like that, okay? So yeah, hated it. Moving right along. This is not a beauty product, but I just wanted to show this to you guys because I love it so much. I just got a new Sidekick and I am in love with it. Oh, it's pink and it's pretty. And I have a Hello Kitty screensaver right there. Oh, so cute. And yes, that is a crack on the screen, and I will tell you how I got that in a second. Basically, last weekend was a really bad phone weekend. So what happened was, on last Friday, I was at my friend's burlesque show, and I was trying to take a picture of the girl on stage. This idiot next to me, this drunk loser, bumps into me, hits my elbow, and right when he hits my elbow, my phone flies out of my hand and it lands in my drink that I was holding in the other hand. I was so mad. I was like, no. So I take my phone out, and it's still working though, right? It's still on. So I'm like, okay, cool. I'm safe. Cool. So I put my phone in my pocket. Half an hour later, my pocket feels really, really hot, and I'm like, what the hell is going on? Pull my phone out, and the screen is completely steamed up, which is so weird. I was like, okay, that's strange. So I take the phone apart because I don't want it to like explode in my pocket and burn my ass. Just not what I want on a Friday night. Normally, you know, when that happens, I normally ask the person to buy me a drink first or something. Anyways, I take it to T-Mobile the next day. I like went out with one of my guy friends and we hung out. And so we went to T-Mobile. I got a new phone because mine was absolutely fried. The inside was completely gone. So I get my new Sidekick. I'm like all excited about my new phone. And then we're hanging out later. We're just like sitting around in the backyard. And I go to stand up and I take my phone with me, and right when I pick my brand new phone up, not even 3 hours after I've gotten it, it falls out of my hands and lands face down on the patio, and that is where I got the crack. I was so upset. I seriously was. Luckily, it didn't break the cells underneath or anything, so I can still use my phone, and I'm probably gonna get the screen replaced this week before the problem gets even worse, but just the fact that I had broken two phones in less than 24 hours is just a very Jackie thing to do. I think, I'm pretty sure it's something only I'm capable of. I should never be allowed to have a cell phone again. I am barely even qualified. Like, seriously, I should only be allowed to make calls using rotary phones and like 2 tin cans and a string, because I'm not qualified to own a regular cell phone. So let's hope I don't destroy this one, because I do love it. It is an excellent phone. So I don't suppose you'd be interested in hearing about some beauty products today. I picked this up at Ulta a couple weeks ago and I'm in love with it. It is the Smoothies Body Cream Body Swirl Buttercream Cupcake Body Lotion. I cannot say enough good stuff about this body lotion, because not only does it look pretty and the packaging is super cute, but literally you will smell like a vanilla cupcake, which the guys really noticed, because the first day that I wore this to work, I had guys coming in my cube all day just being like, "Ooh, you smell like baked goods." Like, but it attracts the men because men like baked goods. It smells delicious. It makes me want cupcakes. It smells so good, and it's actually really moisturizing. So I like this a lot because it moisturizes, but it doesn't leave me all greasy and slippery. So I really like this a lot, and I cannot remember how much I paid for this. I'm gonna list all the pricing information on my blog in a couple days, like either tomorrow or the day after. But I love this lotion, and they have all kinds of scents. They had like a milkshake, and they had chocolate cake and all these other things, and they smell so good. So I highly recommend their body lotion. So this next thing I also got at Ulta, and I got this as a free gift when I bought my shining serum that I normally wear by Kenra, which I talk about all the time, and I love it. So it came with, as a free gift, a Kenra volume spray hairspray, and it's a little size, but I've been using this for about a week and a half, and I really like it, because even though I don't really need anything volumizing, it's very light, and so it doesn't make my hair crunchy. And you guys know I hate crunchy hair. I don't care if you have curly hair, there's never an excuse to have crunchy hair, okay? None. It ain't cute. All right, girl? No. And so that's why I really like this, because it's a really good amount of hold without that crunch that just looks awful. I just think it's so tacky. I really hate it. No crunchy hair, guys. Seriously, this is my PSA. Please avoid crunchy hair at all costs. So once this is done, I'm definitely gonna go buy a full-size bottle of this, even though I'm like afraid to know how much it is, because my hair shining serum itself is like 30 bucks. So I'm kind of scared to know the price of the full size of this. But if it's not like $50, then I'll get it. But you know, I do like this a lot. So this next thing is by Urban Decay, and it's their eyeshadow primer potion in Greed. And it's this really pretty gold primer potion. It's a limited edition, and I actually am really hoping that they end up just leaving this as a part of their regular lineup, because I love it so much. The hell? Ooh, firefighters. Yay! Oh no, they drove by. Damn it. Okay, anyways, now that that's all done, let me show you guys what this looks like. It's so pretty. It literally looks like liquid gold, and I love this because I've been wearing it every day underneath my Rockin Republic gold eyeshadow that I love so much, that I've been wearing in a lot of my videos, and it just makes that gold really silky and velvety, and it really makes it pop, and I love it so much. And I almost feel like this helps my eyeshadow stick better than the regular primer potion, just because I feel like it's creamier, so it clings onto my skin a little bit better. So I really like this, and I do like their new little tubes that they're offering, because I feel like it's easier to get the products out. So highly recommend this. This was $19, I think, and money well spent, because I use it every single day. So the next thing is probably my favorite thing that I got all month, or actually I think I started using this last month, but I was looking for a new foundation because I ran out of my NARS Sheer Glow, which I do still love, but I was like to try something new. And this is by Urban Decay, and it's called their Surreal Skin Cream to Powder Foundation, and the color that I'm using here is called Mirage. And I love this, and I normally really hate cream to powder foundations because I find that they dry too quickly, so I can't blend them properly. And this one actually takes a little while to set, so I have time to blend it all in before it sets. It's really silky, it's not too powdery, and if I need to touch up during the day with the setting powder because my skin is really oily, it doesn't get all cakey and stuff like other cream to powder foundations do when you apply powder on top. So I am in love with this stuff. I'm definitely gonna keep wearing this, and look at how cute the packaging is too. The only thing that I don't like about it is that the color selection, I feel like there's a good color selection if you're light to like medium to tan skin, but this is the darkest color that they have. Again, this one's called Mirage, and I just You know, there's people that are like honey complected or cocoa complected that I feel would benefit from this product. So I think that they need to expand the line and have some darker colors as well. But other than that, I really like this. I just wish that they would expand the color line. A lot of companies do that and I don't know why, because like I get way tanner than this too. So if I get too tan, then I'm not even going to be able to wear this, which is kind of lame. So hopefully they expand that color line. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to talk about, and I'm just going to try to talk through and ignore the sirens because I don't know what the hell is going on outside. I know I didn't do nothing, or did I? No, I don't think I did anything, no. So I think we're good. Cops ain't gonna be busting in here, I hope not. And if they do, I hope they find. So anyways, I actually got this in February and I hadn't really started using it regularly, but I have as of late and I love it. So this is by The Balm, and it's, well, let me show you the packaging first because it's super cute. And it's one of their blushes and the color is called Hot Mama. And it reminds me of Orgasm by NARS. It's this really pretty orangey color, but I actually like this better than Orgasm. It's kind of iridescent. It's really pretty. Okay, sorry. I had to stop because that was really annoying me. I don't know why people can't commit their crimes when I'm done filming, okay? It's very inconsiderate. So anyways, now that I've been wearing a lot of orangey and coral lip gloss colors, I really love this. And so if you're into like the orange and coral colors that are so popular this season, I highly recommend getting this blush. I've been using this probably 2 to 3 times a week and I love it so much, and it looks really cute with like a bronzer underneath. So yeah, it's just like the perfect summer blush. So the next thing is something that I got on Hot Lick, and I got this in early June because I knew my birthday was coming up. This is by City Slips, and it's basically these little flip-flops that fold and you can put them in your bag so when your feet start to hurt, you can change your shoes. And this is what they look like. See how they fold like really thin like that? And so basically what I did on my birthday, because I was wearing these really cute gold sparkly heels and they were gorgeous. Let me show them to you. So they're gorgeous, right? But like 2 hours in after dancing and whatever, my feet were killing me. So on the way home, I changed into these and I was so relieved that I had them because, oh my God, my feet were like on fire. You guys know what I'm talking about? When the bottom of your foot just feels like you're walking on hot coals. And I got these for $14. They do have a website, but I just recommend waiting for Hot Lick to have them on sale because I got them for like half price. But I love these. If you're someone who wears heels and you like to go out, invest in something like this because I'm so glad that I did, because you don't want to be walking around barefoot. You know, when your feet start to hurt and you just want to take your shoes off, you don't want to walk around on the street and catch like herpes of the foot or anything. Okay, you know what I'm saying? So get something like this and you don't have to worry about it. Okay, so the last thing I'm going to talk about, I also got on Hot Lick, and this is by Rockin' Republic. And you guys know I'm a big fan of their eyeshadows. This is like a recent development because I got the gold eyeshadow that I've been wearing lately on there, and I talked about it in a recent favorites video. Still love it. So when they had Rockin' Republic on sale again, I picked up another color, and this one is called Saturate, and it's this really pretty powder blue color, and I am again in love with it. It is so beautiful. Let me swatch it for you guys, but oh my God, it's so beautiful and like velvety, and it goes on so smoothly. And I've actually been wearing this with the gold in the inner corners, and oh my God, it's gorgeous. I actually might do a tutorial on that look because it's so pretty. But I love their eyeshadows. They're expensive if you get them for regular price. I think they're like $24 if you go to the Rockin' Republic website. But if you wait for them to go on sale on Hot Lick, you can get them for like more than half price. So, or less than half price, whatever. So it's definitely worth the wait to check these out. I love them so much. The next time they're on sale, I'm gonna get a bunch more colors. I absolutely love this so much. I can't even like tell you how much I love this eyeshadow. Okay, so I think that is it. I feel like I didn't have a whole lot to talk about, but you know, I'm back in the game. So anyways, I'm on my way out because it's my aunt's birthday. So we're doing like a little family barbecue. So I hope you guys are having a fantastic weekend. If you have any questions about the products mentioned, please feel free to address them down below. I will be posting all the product information, where to get them, prices, and all that good stuff on my blog within the next couple days. So you can check that out as well. And I will talk to you all soon. So thank you so much for stopping by to hang out with me, and I'll see y'all later. Bye.